Hey everyone, I'm Nökkvi.
And I'm Pétur.
And
we
are
the
Birds
of
Play. Wishing you a happy new year.
2021 was quite a year for Final Fantasy fans around the world. And what better way to celebrate than to revisit some of the year's highlights. So, in this video, we are going to be ranking our top 5 Final Fantasy stuff from 2021.
We're going to make a list! The people love lists!
And if you end up loving this video, don't forget to subscribe to the channel if you haven't already. That way, you can become a part of our growing Final Fantasy family. Part of the birdhouse? The nest?
You can also leave us a comment telling us what sort of videos you would like to see us make this year. Or simply leave us a comment wishing us a happy new year. But without further ado, let us take a look back at the year that preceded 2022.
Number 5. Final Fantasy 16. For some, 2021 was partly spent waiting for more information to drop about the next installment in the mainline Final Fantasy series. Namely, the highly anticipated Final Fantasy 16, a game that is being worked on by Creative Business Unit 3, the same unit responsible for the now ludicrously successful Final Fantasy 14. And with Naoki Yoshida, the game's producer, having promised the next big information reveal in 2021, there was good reason not only to be hopeful, but also to just be plain excited. Therefore, whether it was for E3, some PlayStation Showcase, the Tokyo Game Show, or the Game Awards, we all had great fun putting on our clown makeup in anticipation for something that ended up never being revealed. It wasn't until a few days ago that Yoshida issued an apology for the delay, this time promising more news next spring. How is this a highlight, you ask? Well, maybe it isn't technically a highlight, but it is deeply characteristic of what it meant to be a Final Fantasy fan in 2021, earning it a spot on this list. Deal with it.
Number 4. Stranger of Paradise. So, Final Fantasy 16 might have been a stranger to 2021, but Stranger of Paradise was not a stranger. The game's existence had been leaked prior to its reveal as a part of the Square Enix showcase for E3, but even though we had heard about some sort of remake of the original Final Fantasy, nothing could have prepared us for what we ended up getting, a dark fantasy reimagining of the original game developed by Team Ninja, where the main character seems practically obsessed with killing chaos, making for some of the most memorable memes of the year. With another trailer and 2 gameplay demos, we've already gotten a good glimpse into what the game is shaping up to become. I just hope they don't dial it back too much on the chaos in the English version of the final game, as it did in the English trailer, seemingly due to the backlash to the original trailer, because I find the almost kitsch aesthetic of the whole chaos thing to be strangely endearing. But if Stranger of Paradise isn't your speed, you can always try speeding around in Chocobo Grand Prix, which is also slated to be released in March of 2022. In March, we will feast!
Number 3. Final Fantasy VII Remake. Unlike Stranger of Paradise and Chocobo Grand Prix, there are still no news on when the next installment in the remake series will be dropping. Even so, Square Enix made sure that Final Fantasy VII Remake fans wouldn't go starving in 2021 by releasing both Final Fantasy VII Remake Integrate, the upgraded version of the original remake, and Intermission, a new DLC episode featuring Yuffie, as well as Final Fantasy VII The First Soldier, which is a battle royale game for mobile devices set in the world of Final Fantasy VII. So far, we haven't really given The First Soldier a fair shot, since we didn't get that shiny ambassador card and we're still licking our wounds. But the Intermission DLC was really good for what it was, making us hopeful for the next installment in the remake series. Final Fantasy VII Remake was also finally released for PC, although the port doesn't seem to take full advantage of the platform's capabilities, which is a bit of a shame, considering the full price point of the port. That being said, it's great to know that the game is finally available to more people that have been wanting to experience it firsthand. And speaking of Final Fantasy VII Remake, this 3D advertisement featuring Red 13 on the side of a building in Tokyo is very cool. even though it mostly serves as a reminder that I couldn't travel to Japan in 2021 due to the COVID lockdown in the country. Still cool though.
Number 2. Pixel Remaster Series. Announced and released in 2021, the reception of these remasters has been overwhelmingly positive, the biggest gripe seemingly being that they have so far only been released for PC and mobile. A criticism I can get behind, because I would love to be able to play these games on my Switch while I hide away from my children in the bathroom. I know I could just use my phone, but I gave up on it after trying the PC version of the original Final Fantasy Pixel Remaster, both because of the small size of the screen and because of the touch control on mobile. If you haven't played the earlier games, you could do a lot worse than these remasters that let you return to the roots of the series in style.
Honorable mention, the return of Sakaguchi. Speaking of returning to the roots, Hironobu Sakaguchi, the original creator of Final Fantasy, may not have returned to work on the series this year, but he did return to our hearts. He returned with a new game called Fantasian, whose only sin is being exclusive to the Apple Arcade. And he even brought the legendary Nobuo Uematsu with him to compose the music. Subsequently, Sakaguchi also made a return to the spotlight to promote the game. And with all eyes on him, one of this year's most heartfelt Final Fantasy events comes in the form of watching Sakaguchi sharing his Final Fantasy XIV journey over on Twitter. Sakaguchi went all in and finished everything leading up to the Endwalker expansion in record time, all the while taking note of how the game pays homage to the legacy of the series he created.
Number 1. Final Fantasy XIV Endwalker. Now that we've come to the end of our ranking, the release of Final Fantasy XIV Endwalker is the only appropriate answer to the question, what was the seminal Final Fantasy moment of 2021? Endwalker is the culmination of the decade-long rags-to-riches story of Final Fantasy XIV, a game originally deemed one of gaming's biggest failures that was later turned into one of the most successful games in the world. This latest expansion raises the bar even higher for the already critically acclaimed MMORPG, and demand is so high that Square Enix has temporarily shut down sales in order to prevent the servers from becoming too congested. I realize there is a bit of a divide within the Final Fantasy fandom between Final Fantasy XIV players and more general Final Fantasy fans, but in case you are someone that has been sleeping on Final Fantasy XIV just because it's an MMORPG, I beseech you to try it out if you get the chance when they start letting new people back in. Giving it a fair try could even be your New Year's resolution.
I beseech you to try it out.
What a year of Final Fantasy it's been, bro.
It's been amazing year.
And if you've watched any of our videos over the past year, I want to say, I want to extend a personal thank you.
Thank you so much for watching our videos.
It's really loud in my ear.
Keep watching our videos in 2022.
No,
why are you coughing in my face? There's a pandemic, a global pandemic.
Let's end the year with some bird sounds to end all bird sounds. Even though it mostly serves as a reminder that I couldn't travel to Japan in 2021 due to the COVID. fucking hell.